See important safety information at the end of the video.
Older patients in general tend to not be interested in oral opioids as much. They tend to be off of them, so there's no issue with weaning the patients down. And many of them have had side effects as well from oral opioids, so they're not interested in even retrying new ones. So intrathecal pumps in that setting work exceedingly well for a variety of different pain conditions, also usually with very low doses. Well, a geriatric patient that comes to see you really just wants to get better. They're interested in whatever suggestions you have. And so that's where I'm very thankful that I made the decision to implant pumps, because many of them have already tried a wide variety of other things. They've tried the therapy, the injections, the medications. They've either tried surgery or they're not a great surgical candidate. And that's where a pump comes in. And so we'll have a discussion about doing the test for a pump, and we see how they do, and we want to make sure they have substantial enough relief, which most of them do. And then they take our advice and we proceed with implanting a pump. So I like to use the trial as a means to allow the patient to sample what it would be like to have a pump. Many of them are a bit distrustful of what's been done because they've been promised whatever it is going to be the next success for relieving their pain. So when I have a geriatric patient interested in an intrathecal pump, we'll discuss utilizing the pump trial as a means to make sure that the permanent pump would give them the relief that they're looking for. And we discuss that it's a single injection into the spinal fluid, and then it takes about a few minutes to do. I usually utilize a 22 or a 25 gauge needle for that procedure, and then we send the patient home for the day, and I typically bring them back the next day when it's fresh in their mind to discuss how they did, and then we plan out further from there.
The SynchroMed 2 infusion system is approved for the long-term delivery of preservative-free morphine sulfate sterile solution and preservative-free ziconotide sterile solution directly to the fluid around the spinal cord for treatment of chronic pain. Targeted drug delivery should be considered after the patient has tried oral medications or other therapies that have failed or were associated with intolerable side effects. Implanting the system has possible risks, including infection, meningitis, spinal fluid leak, paralysis, headache, swelling, bleeding, and bruising. Pump or catheter problems can cause a patient to experience overdose or underdose and/or corrective surgery. Errors in inserting the needle into the pump refill septum during the refill procedure can result in medication being inadvertently injected into the pocket, resulting in an overdose that may be life-threatening or fatal. Drugs infused through the system may result in adverse events. Refer to appropriate drug labeling for prescribing information and detailed disclosure. Formulations not indicated in product labeling may contain neurotoxic preservatives, antimicrobials, or antioxidants, or may be incompatible with and damage the system. A prescription is required. Healthcare professionals must review the product technical manual and appropriate drug labeling prior to use for detailed disclosure. For complete safety information about Medtronic targeted drug delivery, call Medtronic at 800-328-0810 or visit Medtronic's website at medtronic.com/synchromedsafety.